You may receive it.
But speaking of criminal justice reform, our president had a State of the Union address yesterday. And in that address, he spoke to the need for police reform, invoking the name of Tyre Nichols, saying emphatically and commandingly, as only a commander in chief can, call to action his people. We need to do something. Moving on. like that's what the fuck he said. That's what happened in it. He said Tyre Nichols, that was fucked up. Moving on. Like, that's what happened. So is this the clip or is this a picture?
It looks like it's just a picture. Okay. But
So our president had his State of the Union, and there were several things that I kind of wanted to address from his State of the Union. I think I had put a couple clips in the chat. I don't know if you had those for us just yet.
Yeah, because I did not watch the State of the Union. However, I am interested in seeing the wonderful nothingness of this. So yeah, let's see. Let's see this long ass. Can we please do this?
Can we speech. Do something? Anything? Anybody? Somebody? Everybody? Yeah. You coming up with it, ma'am, or not? I don't know. You know, you could just talk and say I'm looking for it.
I'm coming up with it. Okay. I don't know where you want to start.
Go ahead.
We can start at that first clip that I put in there. You can go either clip you put up. I'm gonna just rock with it.
I've always been way more interested in the rebuttals to the State of the Union. They are never not funny.
They were funny, but they were trash. Sarah Huckabee Sanders had a rebuttal, and she said he was too woke, and woke politics ain't gonna work in this country. That's not what we want right now. And everybody that was watching it was like, "Fuck you mean woke? What he do? What he say woke? He didn't do no wokeness in this whole fucking speech. There was nothing woke about it."
And it's wild that Republicans have strong-armed the word woke to mean essentially giving a fuck about other people.
Right.
And that is literally their definition of being woke. Hey, you caring about what other people think? You're extra woke ass. No. And white people keep stealing our shit.
It's just...
And bastardizing it. They have Christopher Columbus woke.
So while you pulling it up, whatever clip I said to play in the chat. I can't remember where. I'm
enthusiastic about that, but think about it. Have you noticed Big Oil just reported its profits, record profits? Last year they made $200 billion in the midst of a global energy crisis. I think it's outrageous.
Look at Mitchell Leghorn.
When I talked to a couple of them, they say we're afraid you're going to shut down all the oil wells and all the oil refineries.
This was one of the clips.
We invest in them. I said we're going to need oil for at least another decade.
I think you're looking at the one you was looking for was like an hour 40. I think that's a C-SPAN one. If that was the one you were trying to go for.
I don't know if I've said this before. I don't know if Mitchell McConnell is the world's worst senator or the world's most successful human chicken, but it's one of the two. And I'm not even sure if these things are mutually exclusive at this point. Like, I'm not sure if it has to be one or the other. He might be both.
Mitch McConnell is a turtle.
Nah, you seen a neck? That's definitely giving more chicken vibes.
That motherfucker is definitely a turtle. Have you ever heard him talk?
He talks like a turtle, but he looks like a chicken.
He looks like a chicken? Chicken hawk. But yeah, I don't...
Alright, hold on. But while she's pulling up that clip, I just want to let you know that Russell Westbrook has been traded to the Utah Jazz. And D'Angelo Russell is coming back to L.A.
This shit ain't gonna work.
Yeah, so Russell Westbrook
this shit ain't gonna work.
Oh, it's not. It's definitely not for them to boost the Lakers to the playoffs. However, Russell Westbrook has been traded to the Jazz. And D'Angelo Russell is going back to L.A. Good thing Nick Young isn't there because he probably have an issue with that.
D'Angelo is not built for that L.A. lifestyle. He needs to be somewhere in a small town locking them all down.
Four chains on my roll down.
Mm-hmm. We had an hour 40 on this one. Go ahead. There we go.
I was able to start with Obama asking on this issue. Our goal is to cut the cancer death rates at least by 50% in the next 25 years.
We missed that first part.
Cancer from death sentences treat provide more.
And quick shout out to Russell Westbrook for making it further in the playoffs this year than LeBron James.
Dennis McDonough is here at the VA. We had our first real discussion when I asked him to take the job. I'm glad he did. We were losing up to 25 veterans a day on suicide. Now we're losing 17 a day to the silent scourge of suicide. 17 veterans a day are committing suicide. More than all the people being killed in the wars. Folks, VA is doing everything it can, including expanding mental health screening, proven programs
to
recruit veterans to help other veterans understand what they're going through, get them the help they need. We got to do more. And fourth, last year, Jill and I reignited the cancer moonshot that I was able to start with President Obama asking me to lead our administration on this issue.
Pause it real quick.
Our goal is to cut the cancer death rate at least by
50%. Pause it real quick. He's talking about the cancer moonshot. When he says moonshot, he's who's listening to Pooh Shiesty? What the fuck is he doing?
Mm-hmm. Hey, so cancer moonshot.
What he's referring to when he says moonshot is the action taken by the United States in the race to get to the moon, meaning we're going to make an astronomical leap or step forward in the direction of progression because we want to get to the fucking moon. We want to get to the fucking moon before anybody had been to the fucking moon. He said, I want to go to the fucking moon. That's the moonshot. So that's what they're referring to when they say the moonshot. I want to do some incredible shit. So when you say cancer moonshot, meaning like you want to do some incredible shit in the field of cancer, like cure that motherfucker. Now he's going to talk about what they're doing in effort to that goal. Click play. That's what he's discussing.
Turn more cancers from death sentences to treatable diseases.
Can you go back by like 10 seconds, 15 seconds? Families.
It's personal.
You know, if you hit the arrows back, it'll give you like seconds. Death rates. No, the arrows on the keyboard.
In the next 25 years.
Keep going. 15
Turn
seconds.
Turn more cancers from death sentences to treatable diseases. Provide more. I'm glad he did. We were losing up to 25 veterans a day on suicide. Now we're losing 17 a day to the silent 17? Scourge of suicide. 17 veterans a day are committing suicide. More than all the people being killed in the wars. Folks, VA is doing everything it can, including expanding mental health screening, proven programs that recruits veterans to help other veterans understand what they're going through, get them the help they need. We got to do more. And fourth, last year, Jill and I reignited the cancer moonshot that I was able to start with President Obama asked me to lead our administration on this issue. Our goal is to cut the cancer death rates at least by 50% in the next 25 years, turn more cancers from death sentences to treatable diseases, provide more support for patients and their families. It's personal to so many of us, so many of us in this audience. Joining us are Morris and Candice.
Stop it.
An Irishman and the daughter of immigrants from Panama.
Stop it. I don't need to see this bullshit with them two. I don't really care. It's pandering. Every time they cut to somebody in the audience, they're pandering to you. It is not about those individuals. It's all about making you feel good about them acknowledging those individuals to get you feeling like, very concerned about the problem, to get your heartstrings all tugged up. But no, no, no. The man with no name. The man down there with no name. He's privy to some knowledge about an individual who has, I think, some miraculous things to say in the field of cancer research.
Oh shit.
While we're looking for a moonshot.
We ain't gotta go to the moon.
We're looking for some shit to come about, not this here, to come about to affect what he said in his State of the Union. This is prepared remarks. This is not off the cuff. He said, we're looking to try to, over the next 25 years, cut the mortality, the death rate of cancer by 50%. 25 years from now. To put that into perspective, we're currently in 2023. Mm-hmm. We're looking at 2048 for this to half. Now, man with no name. Tell us about the sister.
Dr. Hadea Green.
We ain't got to go to the moon. We just got to go to Alabama.
Fuck the moon, nigga. They sent a satellite that touched the sun last year.
Let's go to Alabama.
The fact that you could touch the sun is...
Damn. Hold on. Not touch the sun. That motherfucker came back. It's been to the sun, touched the sun, and came back.
Not a signal about the story came back.
No. They sent a motherfucking actual satellite in December of 2021 that passed the corona, touched the sun just to see if it could. And came back, nigga. And this lady is looking for $10 million. These boys blow $10 million on lobbying.
Hold on. So, tell them about her.
Oh, yeah. So, Dr. Hadea Green, out of blackness and her black girl magic, somehow atomized a process that attacks cancer cells with no recovery time, no chemo, no surgery, minimally invasive, and some process. And she needs only $10 million to bring this to fruition. And she's out here campaigning for that.
Hey. $10 million for some shit that you just thinking about is crazy. I'm sorry. I'm not going to pay $10 million for shit that you just got in your imagination that you just thinking on about whatever.
I don't know. But what if she has actually done this?
Oh, yeah. She's done it on the spot.
Using nanoparticles.
She just needs the money to rep.
Bullshit. What you mean she done it already? What you mean she done it?
Oh, she's invented this process already with black girl magic. And over her years of training and
not black girl magic, no
science
with the
science
with the degree in physics.
No, not a degree, a doctorate.
I mean, a doctorate is a degree, but
it's a long degree. Though.
Hey, look, Birdman. I put some respect on her name.
But yes, all right, continue on, my nigga.
So yeah, she needs this $10 million to replicate this on the mass scale, but she has completed it on the microcosm. And yeah, she's out here championing for what us poors would think is a nominal amount of money. T-Pain bought a big ass chain that says
big ass chain.
And I think that motherfucker was like $1.2 million. So 10 of those.
Not even 10. You just need 8.5. 8.5 big ass chains.
I mean, when you selling motherfuckers, you're going
to
have to.
So she needs $10 million to start clinical trials on humans to research the efficacy of technology that has been proven to eradicate tumors. Using laser and
cancerous tumors, human tumors in lab rats.
Using lasers and targeted, was it gold plated electrodes or some shit?
I don't want to give away the sauce. I know.
I can't give it away, fam. It's already out there. It's in the article. This is like nanobites or nanos, whatever the fuck it is. It's like gold nanobites, nanomacro, whatever. She's real scientific. She's a doctor. I'm not. She knows this shit, not me. But it's some shit they inject in you, and then they use a laser to heat up the shit that they injected, not into you, but into the tumor. So they inject the shit, I think it's gold or something, into the tumor. And they use the laser to heat the shit up, and it destroys the tumor.
Just the tumor.
Much like a radiation therapy would do to the same tumors, or chemotherapy would do to the same tumors, but with a radiation therapy, it's a much less targeted approach, and it kills tissue around the tumor as well as the tumor. That's why there's so many adverse effects with radiation, as well as chemotherapy. It works in a similar fashion. But this beautiful laser technology that this wonderful woman has come up with is able to strategically target just the tumor that's cancerous and eradicate it, leaving the host otherwise unaffected by the treatment.
Yes.
Anybody that's done chemo or anybody that's done radiation therapy will tell you that there is a recovery process involved with that.
Yeah.
It's expensive. That's sometimes prohibitive to the process. Meaning that the treatment for the shit that's killing me is worse than the shit that's killing me, and I'll just die. Fuck that. That's what people are making the decision about. And this young woman saw her aunt and her uncle go through cancer and lose those battles. I think that's what she said, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She actually named her foundation after her aunt.
Orally.
So this initial research was funded by the government. I forget the exact entity that funded it, but it was funded by up to like, was it a million, 2.5 million or whatever she got to do the initial research to find out if her hypothesis was valid as science works. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She got that initial funding of $1 million, let's say to $2.5 million, just to explore it. Now, after exploring it and finding positive results, she needs another $10 million to get started, and then I think another 30 to like really be invested and complete what she needs to complete, right?
So at this point, it's theoretical, and she needs more money to bring it into law.
Need $10 million to progress it.
into a firm belief.
It took a million when it was just a thought.
When it was in a hypothesis.
But just 10 million.
10 bucks and it will be a law. 10 bucks. 10 bucks.
Now, mind you, the Los Angeles Clippers are playing Luke Kennard $14.4 million to not play basketball very good.
Hey, look,
she just needs $10 million to cure cancer.
I don't give a fuck what Steve Ballmer do with his money. Not a single solitary shit.
But
I don't give a fuck about what the Gates Foundation do with their money. I don't give a fuck. The president of the United States of America is on record in front of the constituency of the United States saying that he is exhausting all efforts to get this shit down by 50% over the next 25 years. When there is some shit right now that exists that you are, if you are not aware of it, then I don't know how you are a human being on this earth talking about the shit you're talking about. You cannot be about cancer research and not know the name Hadiyah Green. You cannot be about the cancer research and the eradication of people dying from cancer and not be serious about funding a woman who has a non-invasive procedure to not cut it by 50%, to eradicate it, not in 25 years. Next year. In your actual presidency, could be the president that cures cancer.
Slow down, Tito Dan.
Hold on. During his presidency, in the last few months, we have sent $48 billion to Ukraine.
How many billion?
$48 billion with a B. $1 billion to Ukraine.
What's the population?
Two days worth of hours.
What's the population of Ukraine?
Oh, now you got me on that one. 37.
Hey, look, I don't know it. I don't know it. I was hoping our producer can get to Googling real quick.
Dave's
43.7 billion. 43.8 billion. I'm sorry.
What, dollars to Ukraine?
No, I'm sorry. No, actually, the population of Ukraine is 36.5 million. It dropped 25% in 1 year, probably because of Russia. But continue on.
Okay, cool. In the United States, an estimated 609,360 people will die of cancer in the U.S. alone this year.
And cancer ain't just a U.S. problem. We making it just a U.S. problem to raise these funds, but the fact that Biden is mentioning funding and this lady can't get $10 million snuck off into the Ukraine budget when they just sent $48 billion.
There are 30, you said 36 million people in Ukraine currently, mm-hmm. right?
Mm-hmm.
600,000 people a year die of cancer. How many people have died in Ukraine over the last year?
Well, that population,
I guarantee you, it's not 600,000.
I'm pretty sure it's probably that because their population went from 48.8 million in 2021 to 36.5 million in 2022.
I know. That's not because of deaths.
Yeah, people are leaving.
There you go.
Yeah. People are leaving, but some of the motherfuckers is dying. There is a war going on outside that no man is safe from.
Do you think? Do you think 600,000 people have died? Hey, look.
Google it. Shit.
Ukraine war casualties.
I know they would tell us one of 1,000 people have died over there.
Hey, look.
I know we was getting them Saudi Arabia, them fucking Iraqi updates every day when a new motherfucker. 2,000 people have died. 3,000 people have died.
Right now, Norway's defense chief, General Erik Christofferson, claim recently that Russia has suffered 180,000 casualties to Ukraine's 100,000, not counting 30,000 Ukrainian civilian casualties. So I am not the math motherfucker on the show, but right now, I am at about 310,000 deaths of this war total. And we spent $48 billion on that shit. We have had, we gonna have estimated in this year, 609,000 of our people die. And our president is on fucking TV talking about he's imploring Congress to enact a moonshot level effort in towards cancer research.
You don't have to go to the moon, moonshot. Just gotta go to Alabama.
Moonshot. And this woman had told you she need $10 million for 609,000 dead. Over 210,000.
Calm down.
I got the math fucked up. Calm down, have you want me to calm down? You tell me what 609 minus 310,000.
These people play Ollie Oxen Free with the goddamn sun.
It's double. And you gave that shit $48 billion, and you won't give this shit $10 million to start. Because you only gonna give just enough to placate motherfuckers.
You know what?
Just enough to not solve the problem, but to act like you trying to solve the problem.
The problem ain't the money ain't in the cure, baby.
It's in the comeback.
and we all know that, but we allow this motherfucker to pimp us by saying, I'm trying, it'll get greater later, baby. No, it won't. You're actively not trying to make it get greater later. You're actively working against it while saying you're working for it.
That's just one of the things
in the State of the Union address that this motherfucker did that people don't call out.
Hey,
they don't say.
Hey, the funniest thing is, that's what I was exactly about to say. What she said was, she said, fuck Biden all live. She blamed it on us. She said, nigga, if everybody talking about her sending her $1, she'd have been at the $10 million. She said,
I just found out about her, and I'm going to send her some money. Ain't going to be nowhere near to get you close to your goal. I'm fully prepared to send you this young Hamilton.
Right. I'm willing to be the straw that broke the camel's back. I'm not gonna be the rest of my straws, but I don't mind being a straw that broke the camel's back.
Hey, look. $10 of my net worth. Compared to $1 million to $2 million of the US's gross domestic product.
Here's my problem. Diddy fucked it over for everybody in legitimate place with me. I gave up my real name and information one time. And if she don't come get this dollar from me by herself personally.
Hold on. What did you get, Daddy?
What
did you get, Daddy?
I voted to die.
Oh, no. See, no. I see. You fell victim there. Wyclef got me. I texted Haiti to 99090 before I started doing the research and realized that the nigga only got 10 cents out of that $10 that my contribution was.
Yeah, I gave a couple bucks to the text on Haiti. Yeah, I don't know where my money went, but I didn't research it. I was just like, oh, this fucked up.
I researched it after the fact and realized that 90% of the money given to the Red Cross goes to the Red Cross, and 10% actually goes to the charity that they are collecting for.
Hey, I ain't seen one of Jerry's kids in 30 years.
Them niggas is loaded.
I ain't seen them ALS motherfuckers since the Ice Challenge.
Africa, I
come up a little bit since them 60 cents a day motherfuckers.
Hey, nigga, I ain't seen I don't know why I dumped that bucket of ice water on my little cousins. I mean, I haven't seen any progress.
Nigga, did you see the problem before you dumped that ice bucket?
Hey, and if they keep burying individuals like Khadijah Green, you'll never hear about the progress on that. Your $10 probably cured that shit. Actually, your $10 didn't cure it.
No, my $10 did not help Haiti at all.
Ezekiel's 15 in 83 put it over the top.
The real problem.
Put it over the top in 83.
We want to start pointing fingers.
Where you pointing your finger?
I said the real problem is all her staff and all them motherfuckers ain't working for free. Boy, start pointing fingers.
Hey, all I'm saying is, and yeah, she did say that. She said foundations like Susan G. Coleman get $1 billion in a year. Actually, I think she said it was multi-billion.
Motherfucker, Maggie Daly got a whole goddamn park.
Hey, and I don't think the Susan B. G. Coleman Foundation actually does anything to cure cancer. I think it goes to like the cancer awareness.
No,
like who the fuck needs to be aware of cancer at this point?
No, we all know
what it is.
No. Susan G. Coleman Foundation will tell you it goes to cancer research to fight for the eradication of cancer.
What did Maggie Daly do other than have cancer?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I don't know. She got a fucking and look, like our producer said, Susan G. Coleman does help people. But again, I will say they help people in the name of making money. They don't help people in the name of in the spirit. They don't help people in the spirit of getting the problem solved and being done. They help people in the spirit of this is a business and this is how we generate revenue. That's what I think. Because you're not finna tell me that the people at Susan G. Coleman have not heard of Khadijah Green and they don't know the leaps that she has made in the field of cancer treatment. You can't tell me that they blind to that. And you can't tell me that, we know that we can cure cancer, but we got to spend this $65 to get Clarence a macaroni meal. No, fuck Clarence, macaroni meal. If it means we gonna solve cancer. I hate to be callous towards Clarence. Fam, think of all the good your sacrifice is gonna do.
Yeah, fuck your potato sign. I mean, Clarence's parents got a real good marriage. So he'll find a macaroni somewhere else. So again, let's donate to Dr. Green.
It can't be about the individual. It has to be about the collective.
Oh, and also shout out to my little cousin TC. What up, TC? My little cousin has completed her chemotherapy, and she is on her way to. She's in the process of getting surgery. She whooped cancer's ass at 25.
That's what's
up. She finished her last chemo treatment the day before her birthday. I think she turned 25. She celebrated by smoking a blunt.
hey look, that's what's up. Shout out to your cuz. Hey look, I salute that. I got a lot of cancer in my family. I got a lot of people that died from cancer in my family.
Mm-hmm.
I have also a lot of people that survive. I don't know about a lot. I mean, I don't know. How do you quantify? I have survivors. I got survivors in my family. I have victims. You know what I'm saying?
Fruitarian ass nigga. He asked a poignant question. How many motherfuckers do you know that have died of natural causes?
I mean, define natural causes.
Yeah.
Like a heart attack?
Exactly. He got you talking like fucking R. Kelly around this motherfucker. Yes. No heart attack is a natural cause.
I mean, technically one. Real talk.
Yeah.
I know one person. And not even... Hey, look, is starvation natural? Is starvation natural?
Yeah, I mean, stop eating from old age. When you get that old age, just stop eating. Yeah, that's kind of natural cause. Heart giving out.
Yeah. Like, not kind of,
I count heart giving out as a heart attack.
Not attack. Nah. It's arrhythmia. It's a different. A heart attack is just
heart failure.
Heart failure and
that's not a heart attack. I'm attributing heart fail all that shit, heart attack, stroke category to me. It's not though. You said it's
those
different.
Are ailments. Those are late in the game ailments, nigga. That's like a fumble on the motherfucking goal line.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, heart failure is when your heart just stopped working. That shit didn't beat all that it could beat.
Okay. I mean, hey, look, again, so my number is at one. Like, real talk.
And the one I'm giving, I'm on the fence. I don't know. She was just old. She still might have went out of here from some other shit.
No, the one I know went out purposefully.
Of her own accord, yes.
Of her own accord. Yeah. To my knowledge, I wasn't the one that was going to visit her at that time.
Yeah, I got both of my grandkids.
I don't tell people what to disclose.
Hey, that's a wild thing. Mm-hmm. I don't know many motherfuckers. Like I said, the one. And I'm skeptical about the one. And that was a wild ass. Because I know a lot of motherfuckers that die old, but they still didn't die naturally. Mm-hmm. Cancer. Mm-hmm. Fucking my grandfather died from asphyxiation from brain dead and shit. Like, none of them motherfuckers died of natural causes. My grandfather probably was going to make it if he didn't go under the knife.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can think of two. Just my two great-grandmothers. And I think they died just being old.
Yeah, my one great-grandmother. That's the one motherfucker. And like I said, I'm on the fence. Because she was bedridden for some years. So I don't know if that was all old age. And she just gave up or... It was a problem. You know, that was back before I was old enough to ask what the fuck was going on.
Right, right, right.
Yeah. Well, why the fuck y'all got me all up in here tied up in the shit angle? It's always it's always old motherfucker that give you the candy and shit, too. But yeah, donate to Dr. Hadia, Nicole Green, and Orlie Smith Foundation. And rest in peace, Hadia Pendleton. I don't know why every time I hear her name, I want to say that.
Hey, look, that, rest in peace, Hadia Pendleton. That was the young girl that was shot. How far, right? Yeah, what's that, Kenwood or some shit?
Yeah.
Yep.
Kenwood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, rest in peace to her.